Opening, I just had an AMA about Dall-E 2 on Reddit. Let's have a look at the most interesting questions they answered. And at the end of the video, let's check out some new Dall-E 2 images.
Okay, so the first question we have is, how often are new invites being sent at the moment?
We invite as many people as we can on a rolling basis, based on resource utilization rate and work volume for our trust and safety team. As we've been getting better at modeling usage and gaining confidence in our safety system, we've been able to accelerate onboarding. We've exceeded our goals by inviting 20,000 users in the last 7 days. The number will go up and down as we evaluate our safety system, but we're committed to getting as many people on the system as quickly as we can.
Okay, so the next question we have is, the thing I'm most curious about is what this kind of technology will look in a few years. And what are your thoughts on the entire movies, TV shows being generated by AI based on a prompt?
Timelines are always hard to predict because of how quickly the field is moving. It's crazy that Dall-E 1 was released only a year and a half ago. Video is a very natural next step, but video is also hairy due to its size. Think of how many images make up a 2-hour movie at 60 frames per second. Still, I'm optimistic someone is going to get there in the near future.
So the third question we have is, what is it like typing your first prompts and seeing pure magic happen in front of your eyes? And what makes someone eligible for an invite?
Whenever I am onboarding someone, I start with the same prompt, a 3D render of a fluffy dog wearing sunglasses in a blue room. I love this prompt because it shows such detail in the fluff of the dog, and the shadowing in the room is always impressive. It takes a moment, but the person I am showing really lights up when I explain, I've run this prompt about 100 times and we never will see the same dog. These dogs have never existed before. Something about that moment helps people realize this isn't just some fancy and mega advanced image search. I love that moment. As for your second question, anyone is eligible. We just ask that they sign up for the waitlist and be patient with us as we work through it.
So from this user, I thought we'd just pick out a couple of questions. The first one is, do you already know if Dall-E 2 will be completely free? Or will it cost something? And what the price models will be in the latter's case?
Pricing. We really appreciate the interest and we know there are a lot of people looking forward to broader access, but we don't have any product updates to share today.
And how many waitlist applicants are being approved each week?
We invited 20,000 users in the last 7 days, but this rate can accelerate or decelerate as we learn more about usage and safety while adding more users.
Okay, so we picked up a couple of questions from this user too. So the first one is, will Dall-E 2 eventually be made available for anyone to use?
Yes. Anyone can join the waitlist. We just ask that they have patience with us as we make our way through it.
And how do you envision artists and designers would use and benefit from this technology like Dall-E 2, and for that matter, a non-artist average Joe or Jane?
I think everyone can benefit from having Dall-E as a creative co-pilot. That being said, I 1000% see a difference in the emotional impact of the images that artists have created versus my own. There is an art to generating amazing prompts, and that is something Dall-E needs a human's help to create.
So, the last question we have for today is, how many images did Dall-E train on for its dataset?
We trained our model on roughly 650 million images along with their captions. These images were either licensed or publicly available on the internet. This was the number of images remaining after filtering out low-quality data, violence, gore, and sexual content.
Okay, so that's all the questions I picked out from the Reddit AMA. So before you leave, check out these Dall-E 2 images.